Hi Geminis, how are you? Well, welcome back to my channel, and I do want to say I missed you so much, you guys. I'm so sorry I was gone for so long and I didn't do your readings, but I'm back. I'm back now, and I'm excited to see what's in store for you for this month. I'm a little late, so I apologize for that, but I think it's still going to be a good reading, and I think you still can get a lot out of it. I'm going to do a little shorter than the usual. That set, I'm gonna do just two rows, one for first part of the month, one for the second part of the month, and I'm gonna pull one oracle card just for your relationship aspect, for your relationships in general, and see what the message comes through for that. So let's start, Geminis. Okay, we have 10 of Swords. We have the Emperor in reverse. I think it's a lot of movement. In the sense of like letting go of egos, letting go of, you know, feeling stuck in a certain way, or feeling so the first part of the month we have the 10 of Swords upright, the Emperor reversed, and then the 7 of Pentacles in reverse. So seven, I do have to say that there is we have the Mercury retrograde starting its retrograde on the 7th. So I think it might be having to do with that. But, you know, going from the beginning, we have the 10 of Swords upright. I think for some of you, there was a moment of June probably was a really intense month for you emotionally. And it's also, you were in your head a lot. There's a lot that happened for you in June that made you think too hard, that you were too critical of yourself, or you just couldn't get out of your own way. But I think starting the month, you're gonna be able to kind of let that go, and like let people help you, let friends help you, and kind of put to rest certain things, certain issues that you had, and you know like let that go, and then see how like restful and peaceful this person is. It's almost like that you kind of like putting some of those swords aside, just letting go of some of those negative thoughts, like that, you know, chatter in your brain that's always telling you something, you know, that is critical, you know, like, I mean, critical in the sense that it's judgmental and, you know, negative about yourself and negative about a situation that makes you worried, that makes you wonder, that makes you unsure and insecure. So you letting that go, like slowly but surely that is happening for you. Know, like starting the month, you're starting a little bit more at peace, a little bit more even though you're still like in your head, but you're not as much, and it's a little bit lighter, it feels a little lighter, and you have people around you that are there to help you. Now then we have the Emperor reversed, and I think with the Emperor reversed, it's like, again, it's like feeling, I think you were, in a way, I think for some of you, feeling so strong. And some of you have to deal with an Aries that's been like really stubborn about about something. And then finally they're turning around and they're seeing your perspective, and you're seeing your side of things. And for others of you, I think it's like maybe dealing with a boss that's been overcritical and that was making you worried. And then again, now they're turning around and they're like, oh my God, I'm so sorry. I was like over like micromanaging you. I was like telling you what to do all the time. You know, like I didn't trust and believe in you. And now like they're like, oh yeah, they're apologizing, or they're changing their mentality and not as so stubborn. They're not so stuck in their ways. They're not like just like, you know, going forward. And for others of you, it's more about having your own power, having your own determination, having your own values, asserting them. So it has to do with assertion. So maybe for some of you, maybe like you know, like when you are so stuck, not stuck, when you're in your way so much, you let some of that power, you give that power away, and now it's time to take it back. You know, but come Mercury retrograde, I think for some of you, you might be feeling this relief in the sense of that maybe, yes, you were worried about it, but you had right reasons to worry about it, but you also made steps to fix whatever the issues were, or like, you know, address the worries that you had. So now you're going to see some of the rewards. But yet again, we have Mercury retrograde happening, so there's going to be like maybe expect some wrenches in your plan. And then the second part of the month, we have the Knight of Pentacles in reverse, which is really interesting because, you know, Knight of Pentacles in reverse, all the knights represent action. Now, when it's in reverse, it's usually Knight of Pentacles is the slowest moving energy. When it's in reverse, it's the fastest moving, and it's moving faster than usual, so you can get accomplished more than you normally would. So then with the Seven of Pentacles here and with the Knight of Pentacles in reverse, I feel like you actually will get to see the results much quicker once this change happens, once this shift happens, when this turnaround happens, once you start asserting yourself. But be careful how you assert yourself, because Mercury retrograde will really, tend to say things that we can't take back, and then we really sometimes just like say something without thinking and it just comes out wrong. So really be careful how you do that, how you assert your energy. But in any case, if you do, there will be a shift, and there'll be a quick shift, and you'll see that. Now we have that Hierophant following the Knight of Pentacles, which to me, it's usually sometimes to do with commitment. Well, in this case, I think it has to do maybe adopting a non-traditional view or non-traditional perspective, or maybe starting something that's non-traditional. Maybe you are like monogamous relationship and all of a sudden you're like, maybe we should be monogamous. For others of you, because we have the Three of Cups in reverse, for some of you might be a third party that's being dropped, or maybe you're the third party that's being dropped, hence the commitment is no longer there. You know, so if you're like playing the third party, you know, like know that that end is coming. Well, you're coming to the end of that relationship, because there will be a choice made between you and the other person. So, you know, it could be you, could be the other person, but somebody is being dropped. Now, the other thing that might come through here is maybe you will hear that some of your friends are getting a divorce, or some of you, for some of your friends are getting are going through a breakup. You know, and then coming back here too, it's like maybe you saw that happen, you know, but you didn't say anything, but you were worried about it, and now like actually it's coming to light. So, you know, for it might be a lot of that thing also popping up for you. It could also be that maybe some of you will be let go from a job because of this, like the battle of egos between you and your boss, or between maybe there is something to do with the company that maybe they don't have the finances anymore, and they're going through a restructuring. In either case, it could happen that you're being let go, or maybe you yourself will decide that enough is enough. I don't have a voice here. This is not the place for me. I put so much time and effort, and now it's like I'm not reaping any benefits. So what's the point of me staying? So you're gonna decide to stay, but know that at the end, yes, this cup, these three cups are in reverse, but you know what? I think you're gonna make the right choice, because let's pull another one. We have the Wheel of Fortune. You're gonna have, there's gonna be a delay of some sort, because we have a 10 here and we have a 10 here. It's either way, you're completing something. You know, there's something that will come to an end. The only thing is like, it's really how you approach that end. You know, because it's either you let it happen to you, or you really step into your power and be assertive and have a voice and really take control of your own life to really have this wheel turn in your favor versus turning into somebody else's favor. Because we have all, you know, most elements here, so it's really about you really stepping into your own power and really, really discovering you know, the efforts that you put in, like, are they worth it? Are they not? Now, if we're talking about relationships, and if we're talking about your relationship, not your friends' relationships, you know, with the Hierophant reverse, which is like commitment, non-traditional, maybe think about like maybe going to having a polyamorous relationship versus a monogamous relationship, right? You might give it a shot, and you might find out that it's not working for you. It's not something that you really want to do. But even so, you might give it a try, and some of you might say, nope, that's not for me. But you might be, that might come up for some of you. And for others of you, you know, in connection to relationships, I feel like there's going to be some ego battles, and there's going to be some sort of like search for knowledge or search for like something non-traditional, something that's a little bit out of your comfort zone, something that is maybe something you haven't thought of before. And then having like this at the end, you know, middle of the month, like 10th through the 15th of the month, you know, there's going to be a reassessment period, right? And then once you do that, once you like analyze that, there's going to be some sort of a moment of like, okay, well, maybe I should try something different. You know, maybe I should try to approach this relationship from a different perspective. Now, for some of you, it might be like that you realize that it's not working for you anymore. And then you're going to be like, no, I just want a divorce. I want to break up. Or, you know, whatever we have right now is just not working. So, you know, you're going to put an end to this. But know that if you do, it's going to take a while for that to happen. Because it's, again, Mercury retrograde. So I won't stay away from like making any big choices and big decisions like that during the Mercury retrograde, because you're making a decision with a blindfold over your eyes, you know what I mean? So it's because you're not seeing things for what they are, because Mercury retrograde puts a fog over our eyes and, you know, like in our minds too, like some things are just not as they seem almost. So I would just really stay away from like making any big choices and big decisions this month. But you really have to stand in your power and really find your voice this month, because I think it's really going to be important for you. And also, like, from the 10th to the 15th, really assess certain things and really see, like, you know, if it's working for you, move ahead, and then really be confident with it. If it's not, put the brakes on it a little bit and then see, maybe you can approach it from a different perspective, from a different angle, whatever the case might be it a job, be it a relationship, be it a, like a home situation, or, you know, whatever else might be, right? But so let me pull a oracle card for your love life, specifically Gemini. Wedding. Okay, well, the situation involves marriage. Well, like I said, some of you will be breaking up. Some of your friends, you'll find out they're breaking up or getting a divorce, so you'll be filing for divorce, or not even that, but somebody might be going filing for divorce to be with you, Gemini, or somebody might be like, maybe they've been single for too long and they just don't want that anymore, and then they'll find it like, you know what, I'm done being single, like that's not working for me anymore, you know, like, it's funny because I feel like for some of you might be in a relationship with somebody that, you know, like marriage is something that they never ever thought that they would ever do, but then all of a sudden it's like, well, you know what, I'm not willing to lose this person. I don't want to, you know, like, I feel so good with them. Like, they make me feel so great that, you know, they will want to be with you. And then they will be like, huh, maybe there's something that I haven't thought of. Maybe it's like, maybe it's not like a wedding where you go to church and do that, but maybe it's a commitment of some sort that you be partners for. Or maybe you're just going to move in together. You know, there's some sort of a commitment of like maybe... But it's an unusual commitment. It's something that for that person or for you, it's out of their comfort zone a little bit, you know, but it doesn't mean that it's bad. So, well, I mean, I'm excited. I'm really curious what this is going to be and how it's going to play out for you. So keep me posted. I'm going to end with this. I'm going to pause this here. And if this resonated with you, please like, share, and subscribe. And just thank you so much for watching and being here with me and supporting this channel. And that's it for now, and I'll see you in August. Okay, bye, Geminis.